Assalamu alaikum, dear professionals. This is Engineer Kamran, Project Engineer Electromechanical, Ali & Sons Group, Emiratul Ula Contracting, Abu Dhabi. First, I will give you a brief introduction about this training, ADQCC and E1. ADQCC and E1 basically is certification consists of two types of exam, which is theoretical and practical for both. Both ADQCC and E1 are two different kind of exams, and both involves two kinds of papers, which is one part is theoretical and other part is practical. So in this training, we will cover both exams and start from theoretical, and at the later stage, we will solve and demonstrate practically designing of LV distribution system to pass ADQCC and E1 exam. So first, let you a brief introduction about ADQCC and E1 exam benefits. ADQCC and E1 exam training will enable students, fresh graduates to pass any kind of interview for the position of electrical engineer, electrical supervisor, and technicians, electrical technician. Moreover, the professionals who have ADQCC and E1 certificates or who knows about the rules and regulations which we will discuss in this training, they have more chances of landing at a good job position in UAE or in any part of GCC country, as the technical part is mostly the same. There are some differences among ADDC and other regulations of different states like DIWA and FIWA or GCC countries regulations, which we will also explain in this training as it proceeds. So let's go to our tutorial for the theoretical training. So there are 5 to 6 exams in the theoretical part. Training for exam 01 starts here. To make it easy and interesting, I divided it into different parts. So you will start with part 1 here. Exam 01, I divide it into different parts. Before proceeding into the question and answers, candidate should write his name, company name, and must note that duration for this first exam is 1 hour. Our first question is about recognizing chapter, regulation, notes, clause, and amended text. Professional should know about document numbering in electricity wiring regulations, year 2020. To be familiar with electricity wiring regulation, professional must understand, recognize the chapter, clause, notes, amended text by respective integers. So usually the question may like this. There will be a screenshot from any page of the electricity wiring regulation with the boxes, empty boxes. So you must write which one is chapter, which one is regulation, notes, clause, and amended text. Chapter is usually represented by integer 1, 2, or 3. Regulations are mandatory and they are represented by one full stop between two integers. Clauses are also mandatory and they are represented by two full stop between three integers. And notes are written in the italic. It is only for information. And amended text are those text which is not mentioned in the previous edition 2014 and mentioned in the current edition. So they are called amended text. Question number 2. Which of the following is correct? Options. Regulations are mandatory and clauses are advisory. Regulations, clauses, and appendices are mandatory. Regulations are mandatory and appendices and guidance notes are advisory. So the option, which one is correct option? In this question, the answer is option B. So you have not only tick option number B as a correct answer, but you have to explain. Explain based on which clause your answer is option B. So in the exam paper, you have to write as per clause 1.3.2 and 1.3.3. So you have to remember or read the wiring regulation
book, and during the exam the book will be with you, so you have to only memorize that from which part I just select this option. So you can just go to that part in during the exam in the book, and you can only just write the class number. Like here the question, the answer is option B, so you have to write 1.3.2 clause, state that the regulation and clauses are mandatory, notes which are included below the clause are for guidance, and 1.3.3 clause, state that the appendices contain mandatory information. So based on these two clauses, your answer is option number B. Question 3, relaxation of any of the requirements of the regulations may be given by which company? Relaxation of any of the requirements of the regulations may be given by the distribution company, the DOE, the distribution company, or DOE. Any, if you are going through some construction engineering phase or during the designing phase, and you need some relaxation to waive off some regulation, so which organization will give you permission to waive off? So these are the three options. So the answer for this is the Department of Energy. Explanation for this: as per clause 1.4.8, relaxation of any of the regulations shall be raised to the DOE, consultant, contractor or owner or customer will raise request to the Department of Energy that give us relaxation from such some for from the subject regulation, as it is not possible to meet. So the Department of Energy will decide either to give you relaxation or to give you some comments. So in this question, the answer is the Department of Energy. Question 4. Who enforce the electricity wiring regulations? Options: distribution companies in the Emirates of Abu Dhabi, distribution companies in the all UAE, the Department of Energy, all of the above. So the answer is option A. Explanation: as per clause 1.4.5 in the electricity wiring regulations, these regulations shall be enforced by the relevant distribution company in the Emirates of Abu Dhabi in accordance with the distribution company relevant procedure approved by Department of Energy. So the guardian to enforce the regulations mentioned in the 2020 wiring regulation is Abu Dhabi distribution company. In Abu Dhabi, they will enforce it. In Dubai, Diwa. In Fujairah, Fiwa, they will enforce. Similarly, in Saudi, this is Saudi Engineering Council, they enforce. Question 5. The electricity wiring regulations shall apply to option A, distribution company customers, option B, licensed contractors, option C, consultants, option D, owners, option E, all of the above. So the answer is option E, all of the above. As per clause 1.4.1, these regulations apply to all the distribution companies, customers, owner, licensed contractors, or any other person involved in the design, construction, installation, or the maintenance of LV electrical installations in all premises. So either you are consultant, owner, main contractor, or distribution company or supplier, you have to work under these regulations. So in your answer, you have to explain this section as well. So this is the end of part 1. See you soon in the part 2 of exam 01. Wassalam.